The commanding general of the 1st Marine Aircraft Wing has flown in from Okinawa, Japan to help oversee the search and rescue efforts. Alexander Zanes continues our coverage with that part of the story. Alexander?
Kathy, Brigadier General Russell Sanborn said today he's here to make sure search crews are getting everything they need. The former aviator can empathize with the families as he went through a rough ordeal himself about 25 years ago.
Brigadier General Russell Sanborn drew from his own experiences today to give the families of the 12 missing Marines hope. After being shot down in Desert Storm, he went missing for 14 days.
For the first 14 days, I was listed as dust wind. And so my wife at the time got the report that her husband went on a mission and did not return. After that status of dust wind, I was converted to the status called MIA. The bottom line is that we have a personal experience that I am not comparing to what these families are going through, but simply that I understand, my wife understands, the tremendous emotional roller coaster that the individuals are probably going through it.
The mood at today's press conference was optimistic. All of the agencies involved saying the goal is still to find these Marines and bring them home to their families.
Our thoughts and our prayers are with those Marine families out there. And really, that's the overriding reason why my Sergeant Major and my wife are here, is just to let them know and to express to them that the Marine Corps and me personally and my family are here for them and to support them in any way that we can.
The Coast Guard echoed that sentiment.
Before I give you a quick summary of our operations on scene, I too want to emphasize that our thoughts and prayers are with the entire Marine Corps and especially with the families and the loved ones of the missing service members.
And in addition to those involved in the search and rescue operation, military officials say there's been a tremendous outpouring of support from the community, whether it's offering to volunteer their time or help with the search efforts. Military officials do still want to remind the public to call them if they spot any debris or anything that could be related to the crash. You can find that information on our website, KHON2.com. Alexander Zanes, KHON2 News.
Thank you, Alexander. We will continue to follow developments of Thursday night's Marine training tragedy throughout the weekend on air and online at KHON2.com.